and great expectations for him. Peter Grant was back for Celtic after a three-month layoff, and it was good to see him. Jock Brown now takes up the story right at the start of what proved to be one of the most controversial matches of the season.
The perfect conditions for another crunch match in the Premier Division. Celtic coming back to Dundee for the fourth time this season after three defeats, two against Dundee United, one in the league, one in the Scull Cup, and one league defeat against Dundee up the road. But that was during their indifferent spell of form early in the season. They're now right back to something approaching their best. United 2 enjoying an excellent spell, second top of the league, and very anxious to keep the pressure on Rangers. Malpass getting back, and Paul Hegarty lofting it forward. Headed down by Bailey, straight to Morris. Aiken is caught late by McAnally. Jim McAnally, a former Celtic player and teammate of Roy Aiken, crunching into Roy Aiken there. Challenge came from Jackson on Barnes. There's Derek White. There's McStay. Jackson and White clash. White to the knock. Logan plays it back, and Derek White has still not recovered from that very firm challenge from Darren Jackson. White looking anxiously towards the bench, referee checking that he's all right. Pat Bonner taking plenty of time about the kick-out. Levy Neal's on his feet, looking at Derek White anxiously. And now the referee has helped there, because Derek White is clearly in some difficulty. No question about that challenge being a foul. There were two very determined players, Derek White and Darren Jackson, going for that 50-50 ball. Jackson won it, and White took that knock around the left ankle. Brian Scott, the physio, checks on Derek White and returns him to his central defensive post. And an immediate change being made by United. Well, that's quite remarkable. The fifth minute of the match, referee Mike McGinley from Clydebank sees Darren Jackson depart and Dave Beaumont come on in his place. Well, look at his found space. Well tackled by Bailey. Beaumont picks it up. Gallagher again. Paatelainen. Come back by White, and Bonner comes to claim it. Plenty of defence and depth there from Celtic. Lots of cover. Aiken calling for the ball on the right side of the Celtic midfield. Header by Malpass. Bailey going up with Gallagher, the cover provided by White. There's Chris Morris. Good play from McKinley. This is Malpass winning the throw off Morris. United have made a very determined start to the match, carrying the fight to Celtic right from the opening whistle. There's Neary. Malpass plays it through, and White is there for Celtic. Now Barnes. Good running by McStay, and he's taken out of the play by David Neary. The referee allows play to continue. Well, that certainly was controversial. A race for the ball in midfield, and this time there's no question about the free kick. It's Peter Grant who goes down. Billy McKinley was the culprit, going in high on Grant. Well, there's two very heavy tackles, one penalised and one not penalised. Billy McKinley is now being warned sternly by referee McKinley. But Celtic were the victims on both occasions. Paul McStay sprinting for this ball loose in midfield. David Neary trying to get back, that appeared to me to be a clear trip, for the referee allowed play to continue. But he certainly stopped the proceedings with this crunching effort from Billy McKinley on Peter Grant. McGee beaten by Hegarty. There's McAnally, fine piece of play. Now Bowman. And the ball held there on the legs of Bowman, and Bowman is very angry indeed about Mark McGee's attentions. Well, referee Mike McGinley suddenly finds himself with a very tough match to handle indeed. Bowman remains calm enough, but he certainly was unhappy about the attentions of Mark McGee as he held the ball with his legs, and McGee tried to wrinkle the ball free. Paul McStay, Aiken, came from McKinley. Morris lobs it forward, McKinley in the corner of the box. Halted by Neri, and Hegarty's clearance finds Peter Grant. An easy one in the end for Thompson. Celtic getting back with a vengeance. Was beautifully taken down by Grant. Was the turn by Morris. You regret that. A fine play by Grant in defence. Applause to the Celtic fans for Peter Grant. Very much a favourite for the Parkhead faithful. Away by Hegarty. Grant now to Barnes. Turned out by Kevin Gallagher. This is Barnes. Hegarty going up well. Here's Malpass. The squad is going forward. Dummy came from McAvaney, the finish from McStay. Oh, what a goal that could have been. Paul McStay coming within inches. But it was all down to the dummy as the ball came forward. Look at McAvaney leaving that, deceiving the entire United defence. McStay is through on the keeper. The shot is angled just wide. McAvaney and played in early by Morris towards Barnes. Breaks back for McGee. Moments quickly in on Anton Bowman. There's McGee at the edge of the box. Fine effort! Brilliantly pitched away by Thompson, asking questions of his defenders, and well he might. The simplest of opportunities, a throw to McGee, who had lots of space around the box, turned. Let fly with that searing volley, which was well saved by Thompson. So just a couple of minutes remaining in what has been a hectic first half. As you make it come forward again, there's McAnally trying to catch out Pat Bonner with a long range of. Touched on by Grant, McAnally wins it for United. Pass from Hegarty, too long for Paatelainen. There's McKinley, got the pressure but reacting very well here. He looks so assured and composed for once a year. There he is, he's Paatelainen. Turned away by White before Gallagher can reach it. Paatelainen waits for the Billy McKinley corner kick. That appeared to skid off the head of Hegarty towards Bonner. But well taken by the keeper, right at that near post. And there goes the half-time whistle. A rough, tough first half with some physical play simmering all the way through. Mark McGee very much involved in the action. He was the player who almost got the only goal of the first half with a tremendous turn shot on the volley, which was beaten away by Billy Thompson. So the score sheet remains blank, but there's lots of action to come. It's Dundee United 0, Celtic 0. Celtic at the second half underway, but no change in their lineup for this period. They have Joe Miller and Andy Walker available, so some attacking players available to bring on as the game goes on. United, of course, having committed both their substitutes owing to the injuries to Darren Jackson and Dave Bowman early on. Bowman with McGee. Eric White playing it on. Here's Malpass. So sure-footed. Morris nodding it into no man's land. It's filled there by McKinley. Gallagher towards McAnally. That's for Paatelainen. And well taken by Pat Bonner. Excellent goalkeeping by Bonner. Gallagher goes down winded. Is he challenged there? But a fine move. The ball was bobbling about around the edge of the box. Nodded on there by Kevin Gallagher. Then it came through to Paatelainen. You can see him try to lob Pat Bonner out. Stretched that left hand to catch the ball. taken. McAvinney. Well, pass chests it down, but he finds McStay closing in very rapidly. McStay battling hard for Celtic. He's nearly. That goes, it will be a throw to United. Ball is still in play. No one through the middle of United. It's Derek White and Tommy Barnes. The wind carrying the ball away from the goal. On the right, he has Paatelainen on the left. Superbly angled cross and well claimed by Bonner. Now a chance for Celtic on the break. United a bit thin in defence for the moment. Here's Paul McStay switching it to the far side to Roy Aiken. Well, he didn't get the angle he wanted in that header, made it easy for Billy Thompson. Celtic certainly got players forward quickly on that break. Barnes plays it back, here's Derek White. Here's McAvinney, with the shadow David Neary. Morris comes up in support. Good play from Morris. That was angled on by Jim McAnally's defensive effort. Good catch by Willie Thompson. Celtic's throw. Here's Mark McGee. Stopped by McAnally. It's Kevin Gallagher. McKinley plays it through the channel and turn that channel for Gallagher. Powering into the box. Penalty kick has been given. Now that is certainly worth the best one. Penalty kick to Dundee United as Gallagher. Again, as Gallagher was sprinting through the inside left channel, followed by Baillie. So the question is, did Gallagher stumble or was he fouled by Baillie? It looked as though Gallagher stumbled without being punched. So a moment of high drama here at Tannadice. Certainly looked to me as though Kevin Gallagher stumbled unaided by Baillie. But the referee saw it from a different angle, he saw it differently. And a penalty kick it is. It'll be taken by Mixu Paatelainen, just 21 years old, a Finnish international.
Very long one indeed for such a small player. Hegarty won it.
Header reached Mark McGee. He tried to turn the shot on target, but couldn't quite make it. There's McAvenny. Paul McStay. McAvenny. And it's David Neary again who blocked the shot. A very good effort by McAvenny. Challenging, got to the ball first, but under pressure from Thompson, couldn't direct the header downwards. So Miller back to Rogan. Four men now committed to attack for Celtic. Miller, McAvenny, McGee and Walker. Here's Miller. Taking on Beaumont. Tackled by Beaumont. Roy Aiken in the box. So is Rogan. One by Neary. It's Paul McStay. Great effort from McStay. Oh, showing tremendous awareness there as the ball was controlled in his chest. Resisting the temptation to pass wide to the left and rifling that shot just past the post. That's Hegarty and McKinley. Paatelainen with Malpass supporting. That's Phil Gallagher. Great play from Dundee United on the break. Taking on Baillie and brought down at the byline. Well, a rush challenge that by Baillie. Gallagher appeared to be carrying the ball over for a goal kick in any event. The big centre-half lunged in with a challenge. A free kick to United. Paul Hegarty is up, looking for the goal which will clinch the match for United. Jim McAnally will take it.
Goal right at the end from Baillie.